With all the hype around SpaceX's recent Starship test flight, I thought we should talk about six ways that I think the SpaceX Starship is changing the game. Let's go.
Go for deploy. Under speed, lift to the right level. Contact right.
Hey guys, Tori here from Overlook Horizon, and welcome back to 2 Minute Tuesday, which is where we talk about space, sometimes science, for 2 minutes. It's not really 2 minutes, but we do it anyways, every Tuesday. So be sure to subscribe so you don't miss it. Why do we say 2 minutes? I don't know, but we'll put it on the clock anyways. And let's get to today's 2 Minute Tuesday. Now, most of you probably know that the SpaceX Starship is their next generation rocket that is intended to take humans to the moon and Mars. But why is it such a big deal? And is it even working? For the past almost 2 years now, we've seen a mixture of success and failure, but this publicly visible development is something we rarely see with other spaceflight companies. I mean, SpaceX is building this out in the open where just about anyone can see what's happening.
Tony Stark was able to build this in a cave with a box of scraps!
But it's this sort of mentality that makes it a game changer, and here's why. Number one, it will be fully reusable. A fully reusable super heavy lift orbital rocket has never been done before, but this is a key component of the future of spaceflight in order to reduce costs and make it more accessible and affordable for both government agencies like NASA and also private organizations. Lower cost means more players in the game and ultimately more flights. Number two, fast evolution. SpaceX's build strategy is build, test, fail, and repeat. This is an unusual strategy in the spaceflight world, but it allows SpaceX to rapidly evolve their designs. Compare that to something like NASA's SLS program, which has been in development for nearly 10 years without a single test flight and huge cost overruns. Number three, stainless steel construction. One of the main reasons SpaceX switched from its original design of carbon composites to stainless steel is because of the cost. Stainless steel is much less expensive and much faster to manufacture. In fact, we've had stainless steel rockets in the past, like this Atlas, which was so thin that it could collapse under its own weight if it wasn't pressurized, which it did in 1963. Thankfully, advancements in material science since then give us better options now. Also, interesting side note, they needed to invent a special oil coating for the Atlas to prevent it from rusting. You might have heard of it. It's called WD-40. That's what it was invented for. Now, stainless steel can also handle re-entry heating very well. One of the earlier design concepts called for the vehicle to use this liquid methane sweating method to cool the windward side of the rocket, but it appears that SpaceX will now be utilizing heat shield tiles mechanically affixed to the vehicle. One problem I see with that is that this is the only part of the vehicle that may require regular maintenance or replacement, so I'm not really sure how they intend to handle that in the long run for, say, a return mission from Mars to Earth. Number four, Methalox engines. This is truly a spacecraft with Mars in mind. Methalox engines, like SpaceX's Raptor engines, use methane and liquid oxygen, both of which can theoretically be pulled from the Martian environment, making it possible to someday refuel and return a Starship back to Earth using just the local resources. SpaceX is also exploring switching their RCS thrusters from cold gas nitrogen to hot gas methane to further this reusability concept. Number five, Onorbit refueling. This has been a spaceflight dream for years, but SpaceX may finally bring this to fruition. NASA has already invested in this concept with SpaceX, which could allow the vehicle to bring huge payloads to a place like Mars. And finally, number six, diversity. This will be SpaceX's next vehicle, and it will likely replace the Falcon 9 altogether. Sure, Starship will be capable of flying astronauts to the moon and to Mars, but there's no reason it can't be used for crew transfer to the International Space Station or for satellite launches into Earth orbit. They've even talked about using it to fly passengers to just terrestrial Earth destinations like an airliner. The power of the vehicle might be a bit overkill, but since it's completely reusable, the costs will be incredibly low. So that's where I'm going to wrap up this week's 2 Minute Tuesday. That's not really 2 minutes long, but it is what it is. If you have other burning space questions you think I should cover, drop them in the comments down below. As always, be sure to click the like button, consider subscribing, and I'll see you on the next video. Goodbye. Bring this to fruition.
Fruition.
Fruition. That's, why did I put that word in there? Be sure to click that like button.